Hello everyone, welcome back to X-Plane 11. Today we are once again flying the Innobilds Airbus A300 600 variant. We are flying a UPS flight again. This time we'll be starting off in Birmingham, Alabama, and we'll be flying back up to the UPS headquarters up in Louisville, Kentucky. Today's flight, we're looking at around 52 minutes, cruising altitude 33,000 feet. Weather here in Birmingham, just some light winds from the south, 10-mile visibility, scattered clouds at 3,700 feet, and scattered again at 7,000. Weather in Louisville right now, We're looking at rain and an overcast of 4,200 feet. Temperature 10 degrees. Some light wind as well coming in from the southwest. Looks like we're not going to have many problems while cruising. Some winds coming in from the west. But we will definitely be planning for a wet landing in Kentucky. Just gonna go ahead and jump into the cockpit here. I did already align the IRS, so I still gotta put in the rest of the data here. Flight number UPS 701. Cruising altitude 33,000 feet. Cost index 27. And the cruising wind is 254 at 64. There we go. Before anything else, we're going to load up the plane. Our zero fuel weight, we're looking at 267,000.8 pounds. Fuel on board, 25.8. Load that. Come over here. Okay. No, that's not what I wanted. 0.8. Thank you. Zero fuel weight again. 267.8. And the center of gravity is 27.0. We'll be taking off Birmingham, runway 24. Pull the ATIS. And there we go. Compute. Actually, we'll be doing a TOGA. There we go. So then we can just send that over to the FMS. There we go. We got our takeoff data, our approach, our wind correction is going to be plus 5. Decision height, 200 feet. Go around, could be possible, depending on how bad the rain is. Oh, we'll put in our flight plan. Birmingham SID, taking off via the Birmingham 8. It's not what I wanted. Sometimes you gotta put the runway in first, so. There it is. 24, Birmingham 8. Insert. Our first waypoint is Rhett. R-H-E-T-T. Get in there. And then direct Nashville VOR. Why are there a lot of them? 114.4. That one. And then from Nashville, fly to Embell. Hello. And then Louisville. 17 right. The Embell 4. Spurs transition. Take out that one. We'll leave this discontinuity there. Those will be our vectors for final. Actually, we don't even need to push back. We're all good here. For some reason, this is the only cargo spot available when you load up at this airport, and I don't even understand what this is. Assuming we're gonna have to. I don't even know if we can fit the plane over here. Well, we might. Gonna try it. Is it gonna fit? Yeah, it's gonna fit. It's pretty dangerous though, I don't know. Alright, we'll do it anyway, and then the FAA will write to us. But I don't care. Don't need to do anything down here. Our ILS frequency is 110.3 with a course of 170. That. We'll just give ourselves a random squawk code. Put that in there. Turn the transponder on when we have the engines running. I think it's fuel pumps going here. And start the APU so we can disconnect from ground power. It's like normal sun looting. flying with the General Electric engines today. I haven't really flown with those. I know, obviously, it's probably the same performance. But I like the way they sound, so we're going to fly with those today. APU on, APU generator on, external power off, and we can disconnect the GPU. Tesla, that we close the doors and begin the engine start sequence. No pushback is needed. We get rid of the air stairs too and those. Alright, so I'm loading, the cargo door is closing. Slowly. We'll get the beacon on. Turn on the fasten seatbelt, no smoking signs. We do have two passengers on board. I guess we're just gonna try and squeeze in there because I don't know where else we're gonna go. Unless we do a U-turn over here. And go this way. I'm not sure we'll fit, but we'll be good. Okay, doors are closed. You can go ahead and get rid of the loader. Beacon on, nav lights on, APU on, hydraulics on, APU bleed on. We are ready to go. Start engine 2. fuel. Waiting for the engine to stabilize. Alright, engine 2 is stable, we can start engine 1. Generator on. Get the heaters going. Let's start from there. Alright, do this. And generator 1. Turn on the engine bleeds. Turn off the APU bleed. Alright, both engines are stable. We can turn off the APU generator and shut it down. Work well altimeter 3011. Landing elevation is 500 feet. Got it. All right. Yeah. Get the TCAS on. Do our flight control test. Down, up, right or left, right or right, spoilers, our flight control test is complete. We're taking off flaps 15-15, so that's setting 2. Auto brake max. Spoilers. Armed. And we are looking for the flaps to come down and we'll start our taxi. Alright, slash flaps down. We are good to go. Yeah, I think we'll squeeze in there. We'll fit. Take off trim 1.1. It's one. That's about right there. Oh yeah, we're gonna fit. So once we get out of here, we can take taxiway alpha all the way down to 54. Nice little taxi out to the runway. Why I get those stutters. I mean, it's really, I have a high spec computer. I wonder if it's the enhanced Skyscan plugin. I refuse to flex without it. Default just looks horrible. X-Plane 12 though. From what I've seen, the weather engine that they use looks a lot better than X-Plane 11. So that's something to look forward to. runway 24, report takeoff checklist, flight controls check, briefing confirmed. Slash flaps, 1515, performance. We already checked that. Takeoff configuration, check, transponder set, cabin is secure. TCAS is already TARA, packs required ignition, we're going to set them to continuous relight. Anti-ice, we don't need that now. We will probably need it around 10,000 feet or so. Alright, landing lights, takeoff, strobe lights. Center line just a little bit. We'll fix that when we start rolling. Oh yeah, we're way off. Oh well. Right, we'll spool them up to around 40% N1. Alright, brakes off. Set them to toga. V1 and rotate. Positive reestablished, gear up. Lights off. Approaching our top altitude. Laps up. And we will set our speed bug to 250 knots. Now we're in climb power. If it'll let me scroll. Here we go. All throttle is on. We're going to fly direct to Rhett now. And climb up to cruising altitude. There's nothing wrong there, it's just speed. We're actually going to decrease it to 240 knots. cruising speed to 200 or 2,500 feet a minute. Takeoff climb checklist, last flaps retracted, landing gear up, packs on, altimeters are both set to be local. And calm climb out here. Loving the weather. 10,000 feet AP on. Don't do that. I will increase our speed to 290 knots. Turn off the continuous relay. Landing lights can come off as well. Turn on the anti-ice. Standard pressure. You get the passenger seatbelt sign off for the two passengers on board. And 18,000 feet. you guys can see on the bottom right hand side on the map, that's what we're going to be flying into. Probably not going to be in the red, but we are definitely going to be getting some rain. Actually, kind of do a pre-landing performance configuration here. Should be stopping between 1500 and 2200 meters. The runway is almost 12,000 meters, so we won't have a problem as long as we don't end up floating across. That's the wind right now. I don't know what the winds are like in that storm cell you guys can see on the bottom right. But as long as that is not there when we get there, we should be experiencing too much wind on the approach. Did I get the wrong one? I think I did. Alright, we're gonna make a little amendment and we're gonna fly direct to Embell. Looking at at my map here, and it was showing that we were not going towards the Nashville VOR. I guess I selected the wrong one out of the 50 that were listed. Whoops. And we have reached our cruising altitude of 33,000 feet. We're about, let's say, 130 miles from our top of descent. So at this time, we can go ahead and sit back and relax and begin our descent in about 20 to 25 minutes or so. So we did just begin our descent down to Louisville. And as you can tell, we are hitting some nice little turbulence here. Looks like it's gonna be like this. Hopefully not all way down. Once we're below the clouds, it should be a little bit smoother. Get that fasten seatbelt sign on. Oh, there's the airport directly in front of us. We'll be landing on this runway right here. Thank you.
heading bug on. Left of 4,000 feet, we will proceed direct to Spires, and at Spires we will engage the Autoland, and once the aircraft captures the glide slope, we will proceed to the airport. Flats down to 15. And there's 4,000 feet. Direct Spires. Flaps to 15 now. We are now at the 15-15 configuration. And glide slope is captured. Speed to 160 knots. Approach speed is 139 plus 5, so that's 144. About 7 miles now, landing gear coming down.
5 miles, flaps full.
Alright, landing lights on. Seatbelt signs on. Spoilers armed. Landing gear, 3 greens down. Flaps full. We're good to land. Turn off the auto throttle. And I do have a visual of the airport. I can turn off the autopilot. Looks like we're a little bit below glide slope.
Yeah, we are.
Gonna bring the plane up just a little bit. There we go. Continue. Set her down. Ooh, a butter landing. Spoilers out, reversers on. And there's 80 knots, auto brake off. 60 knots, reverses off. I think that's actually my best landing I've ever had in this aircraft. I'll take it. I'm gonna turn the brake fans on. Alright guys, welcome back to Louisville, Kentucky. The speed brakes down. Flaps coming up. Landing lights off. Taxi light on. Taxi light on, strobe light off, continuous relay light off, I'll turn the APU on, get that started. turn the taxi light off. To this cart here. Stop right there. Okay, parking brake off, APU generator is on, fuel cross speed valve off, and we can turn off engine 1 and 2. Alright, engine is shutting down. Has the seatbelt sign off. Anti-ice off. Engine bleeds. Impacts off. APU bleed on. Generators off. Get the loader there upstairs. We got the brake fan on. Down those brakes. Oh, I almost had it lined up with that. So close. And because there is no flight after this, turn off the beacon, hydraulic pumps, turn off these fuel pumps, and we will connect external power, turn that on, APU generator off, turn the APU off. ATS off. Smoke detectors off. Probe heat off. Window heater off. We're gonna unlock the cabin door. Turn off the IRS. Turn off our nav light. Begin the unloading process. And we can shut off the aircraft. Now running on battery power, and we'll turn those off. And there it was, UPS 701 from Birmingham, Alabama, up to the UPS headquarters in Louisville, Kentucky. Next flight, we'll be back in Microsoft Flight Simulator flying Spirit Airlines from New Orleans, Louisiana over to Houston, Texas.
Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.